Hey everyone, this is Peter from Roland. I'm really excited to show you the MC-101 GROOVEBOX. The MC-101 and the MC-707 share the same powerful sound engine and sequencing power. The MC-101 is a battery-powered 4-track version of the MC-707, so you're able to take it pretty much anywhere and compose really great sounding music. Getting started on the MC-101 is really simple and straightforward. I have 4 tracks at my disposal, which could be anything from tone tracks, drum tracks, or loops, or pretty much any kind of sound that I want to use in the sequence. I can select a track. In this case, I'll select a drum track, pick a drum sound, go to the sequencer, and put in some notes. I can go back to the drum sound page and then pick out anything like a hi-hat. I can look at the note properties here as well, so I can adjust things like nudge, mute percentage, sub-step, more advanced features that are found commonly on more advanced drum machines I have access to on the 101. I can also go back to the note page and play in things in real time. And you'll notice that they're unquantized, which is really great if I want to create something that's a lot more natural sounding, but I could always go in and adjust the quantized percentage just to nudge it in the right direction so that it kind of locks it into the timing. Now, if I want to start composing some melodies, I'll go over to a track that has a melodic sound on it. I could real-time record that in. Go to the quantize and tighten that up just a little bit. Now, in terms of control, the MC-101 has knobs that let me shape the sound in real time. Each knob corresponds to each track. I can adjust multiple parameters across all the 4 tracks. You also have scatter, which is a performance effect that lets you chop up audio from each individual track or the entire mix out. It's an excellent way to make dramatic effects when you're performing, or it's really cool to sample yourself when you're producing something. So if I hit the scatter button, I can play each one of these pads and get a different type of scatter sound as soon as I play it. There's a lot there that's drastic, but there's also some subtle effects that you can design yourself. And if I want to go into the scatter settings, I can tell it which track I'm affecting. So in this case, let me switch to the drums. So now the melody is unaffected, but the drums are being chopped up. At this point, I can resample anything on the MC-101 down to each individual track. And so if I want to resample the drum track being chopped up, that's as easy as selecting the looper track, going into an empty clip, going back to scatter, and then hitting record. Now it's recorded all of those effects on track 4, and the dry drum tracks are on track 1. So I can bring in track 4 whenever I need a drum fill that's been pre-recorded. I can also apply effects to it as well if I want to use a delay send. Or do something even more drastic, like reverse it. I can go even further and take any sample that I've resampled and start pitch shifting it as well. Let's say you have some clips recorded and you want to set them up for live performance. I can trigger clips independently on each individual track, and also save scenes, which are a combination of those clips. I can save this as my first scene, and then start to bring in different elements of the song, like this pad. I'll save that as a second scene, and then bring in a bass line here. save that as a third scene. And bring in my drum, bring in a drum loop, change the pad instrument, and use that as my fourth scene. So now when I'm performing this, I can go back and trigger these in whatever order I want.